Hi, welcome back to CADable. This is Engineer Ibrahim Omar, and today we'll be creating a 2D drawing of this block in SolidWorks. And I'll be providing its link in the description, and you can download it from my GrabCAD portfolio. This 2D drawing tutorial was asked by one of my subscriber Hassan Ahmed to make a video on 2D drawing. So let's create it. We can create a 2D drawing from here, make drawing from part or assembly, or simply go to here and click here drawing. Both options are same. So let's go to here, make drawing from part or assembly. It is a part, so click here, and now you have your standard sheet sizes, A0, A1, A2, A3 or A4. I will use A3 for this tutorial, and you can also browse some more sheet sizes, and you can also create this, and we can also have our own custom sheet sizes, but I will use A3 for this. So click OK, and now you will see a view palette here and your standard views. So I'll drag this front view and along with the top view, and let's say a right side view and an isometric view, and I'll press escape. Let's say I want to change the scale of this drawing, so click here, and now I will go to here, and here you can see the scale. Currently this scale is 1:1, and I can change the scale, so click here, use custom scale, and let's say I want to change this to 1:2, or maybe 2:1, or also I can change it to a custom scale. So let's say I want to make a scale of 2:5, which is a non-standard scale, and here you can see that. So let's change it to 1:1 and click OK. Also let's say I want to change the visibility, and I want to change it to let's say hidden lines visible. So click here, hidden lines visible, and now you can see that hidden lines visible in all of the views. So click OK, and let's say I want to change this isometric view to this one, shaded with edges, and I will change the quality from draft quality to high quality, and click OK, and now I will drag this to here. Okay, so let's dimension these, and we have a couple of options for dimensioning in SolidWorks. So let's use auto dimension feature. So first of all, I'll go to your smart dimension, and I'll use this auto dimension feature, and I'll choose this one, and here you can see that the horizontal dimension is this one and the vertical dimension is this one, and I can also choose origin, but either you can use this option or this option, and choose OK. So here you can see that all dimensions associated with this top view are displayed, and I can also adjust all these dimensions. Just make a window and select all these dimensions, and just go to here, and now I'll choose this auto arrange dimensions. So you can see that your dimensions are arranged, but I think this option is not good for this drawing. So I'll press Ctrl Z, and now I will use another option for dimensioning, this one, model items. In model items, I'll use this option, entire model, and I'll use all these annotations, and I'll also click this one and click OK, and now you'll see your all dimensions are appeared, and I have to arrange all these, so I'll make a box here, and I'll select all these, I'll go to here and click this one, auto arrange, and now your dimensions are arranged. I will delete the unnecessary dimensions, so I delete this 120 degree, and also this one, and okay, so I'll adjust all these, and let's make this one here, and this one maybe here, and this one maybe here. Okay, so next is we can also make manual dimensions. So just go to here smart dimension, and let's say I want to make a manual dimension here. So select this one, and this one. Just click OK, and I'll delete this one. Now we will apply some tolerances to these dimensions. So click this dimension. Now you can see option called tolerance and precision. So currently no tolerance type is selected, and let's say I want a tolerance bilateral, and let's say in the positive side I need a tolerance of 0.2, and in the negative side I need a tolerance of 0.1, and click OK. So basically it means that your manufacturer has a tolerance of let's say 11.9 to 12.2, and let's say I need a tolerance here, and let's change this to let's go to here, and now I'll change this to symmetric, and I'll change this tolerance to let's say 0.1, and click OK. So you have a tolerance in both sides. Let's make a unilateral tolerance to this side. So click here, and let's change it to bilateral, and now I will only give a tolerance in one side, let's say in the positive side. So in the positive side I will write let's say 0.3, and in the negative side I will leave it as it is. So it will be a unilateral tolerance. Another very important option is let's say I want to change this angle to let's say 150 degree, and when I will change this angle, so my drawing will be automatically updated and my part will also be updated. So let's make it, let's change this to let's say 150 degree, and click OK. Now you will see that nothing has happened, so I have to update my model. So click here rebuild, and now you'll see that the angle was 120 degree, and now the angle is updated to 150 degree. So this is the power of parametric. And let's say if I'll go to my part, my part will also be updated to 150 degree. So let's click here, and I'll click this open part, and now you'll see that the degree was 120, and now the this degree is 150. So this is the power of parametric. Let's adjust these dimensions. So another important command is I'll use this option, hole callout. So let's click here, and we have two holes. So let's check this one, and click here. So it is showing that we have two holes, 5.5 through holes, and the counter size is this one, and the depth of this counter is 3.58. Okay, so let's make some section views, and let's go to here drawing, and go to here section view. And here we have four types of cutting lines, this vertical, horizontal, and auxiliary, and this one aligned. So I will choose this one, horizontal, and I'll make a section view here, click OK. And for the rib feature is this one, click OK. And now you can see your section view. So I'll make a section view here, and section is CC. And let's say I want to break the alignment because there is no space here, and just right click here and go to here alignment, and click this break alignment. So the alignment is broken, and now I can place my section view anywhere in the drawing. So just drag here, and I'll drag this to maybe here. Let's make a detail view, and I need a detail view of high quality, and I'll make a circle here. And now my detail view will be appeared, and I will drag my detail view to here, and I'll reduce the size of this circle. Okay, let's say I want to increase the size, the font size of my dimensions. So just select all these and click this other, and uncheck this box, go to font, and choose this bold, and maybe I'll change this to 4 and choose OK. And now you can see that your dimensions are visible. Let's change this to, let's say, I'll go to here again, others, font, and let's make it regular, not bold, and change it to 4. Okay. Lastly, I will edit my, let's say, this title block. So go to here, sheet, just right click and choose this option, edit sheet format. And now you can change your title block. Let's say this drawing name, my name is Ibrahim Umar, so I'll change this to Ibrahim. I can also change this font size from here and different fonts here. Also, you can edit your material here, drawing drawing number, title, and this drawing paper size, your sheet scale, weight, all the things here. Well, we can add some let's say some text. So click this here, note, and I'll make a note. Let's say this view is isometric view, so I'll write it as isometric. And I'll select all the text and I'll change the font size to maybe 6, and let's cancel this, and you have your text here. Let's change this to small letter and okay. We can add some instructions as well using this feature note. And let's say we can add some features like all dimensions are in millimeter, or remove all sharp edges, etc. So lastly, I will save my file to PDF. So I'll go to here and I'll choose this option, save as. And first, let's say I will choose yes. And now this file type is SolidWorks drawing. So let's change it to PDF, and I'll choose this option, PDF, and I'll choose this option, save. And now your drawing is saved, so I can open this drawing. And now you can see your drawing you have just created. It is not the best one, but it will be a helpful for the beginners. So that's it for today's tutorial. I hope you like it. And if you have any questions, any queries related to this tutorial or any other tutorial in my list, you can ask in comment section. Thanks for watching, and please subscribe to our channel for more informative and interesting videos. Thank you.